Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done. Today's junk, I'm going to take you through my tool bag that I carry with me just about everywhere. Now this tool bag kind of came out of evolving with this landscaping business that I've been doing. A lot of times I get what we call the Hey Kenyas. While I'm there, I'm trimming bushes or whatever I'm doing landscaping wise, I occasionally get questions like, hey, while you're at it, could you replace this light bulb and odd jobs like that. So I started carrying around a tool bag with very basic handyman tools, just in case I get any jobs like that. And I've even been advertising for that kind of thing on Craigslist, and I've been getting calls and texts left and right. So having this set of tools has been very, very beneficial. And to be honest with you, all I did was take tools that I had in the garage anyway and just put it in this bag. Now the bag itself is a Husky bag from Home Depot, and it was about $90 for a set of three. Now, normally, this is $90 for just one, but this was like a leftover Black Friday special. So it's a rolling tool bag that has like one of those suitcase handles that go up and down. And the other two bags can actually sit on top of that main bag and drag the whole thing around. Now, normally, I don't drag all three around because of all the weight with all the tools, and I don't want to break that handle. It is not a professional grade bag, but it's been doing great for me. So let's take it to the van and see what we got. So as you can see, it's a set of three bags. You have a small bag, medium, and a large. And the large is where I keep all the actual tools. So we'll go through very quickly the bags and what I carry around with me. And I just keep this in the back of the van, depending on what my loadout for that day is. If I have the stump grinder like I do now, or if I have to have all my chainsaw cutting equipment, whatever, even a snowblower, I can keep all this stuff in here, just in the back up towards where I sit, and it seems to fit fine. For transport, normally I stack these up on top of each other and kind of bungee them to the headache rack that I have inside the van. So this first bag is the smallest bag, and I think this is like a 12 inch thing, maybe 14. This is where I keep all my consumables. So I have some caulk, I have some tape, nothing fancy. This is just like quick repair stuff, kind of like didn't know I was going to need it type of thing. I have some nails, some wire nuts, you get the idea. Wood glue, zip ties, sandpaper, just regular run of the mill. And I also have in here extra outlets and some wall anchors and stuff like that that I've just collected from other jobs and just from having them at home. I figure I could put them in here rather than taking room up in my own garage. I'll keep them here in case I ever need it, save time, speed up productivity. The next bag, let's get this out of the way and get to that one. This bag is where I keep all my power tools that I might need, a drill and a driver mainly, but I have all the bits and everything that go with it. So just drill bits, I have more drill bits, masonry bits, and just basic run-of-the-mill bits. So inside here I have my driver and my drill. Okay, I also have the Ryobi oscillating multi-tool. This thing is great. I use it originally, I got this to work on vehicles because it's got a ratchet attachment that you put on top, and it's very underpowered for what it is, but it does remove bolts a lot faster than I would by hand. So normally what I would do is break them free with a breaker bar or ratchet and then throw this thing on there and speeds things up. It takes Ryobi regular 18 volt batteries. Use that, and then I just have Sawzall blades. I keep a cordless Sawzall in the van on one of the shelves, and a corded one as well. And then I got tool belts and pouches. Nothing crazy. Now, as far as the Ryobi multi-tool is concerned, you might be thinking, why am I carrying a ratchet? This is why I carry it. This is the oscillating head that would go on there instead of the ratchet attachment. You can do scraping, you can do cutting, all kinds of stuff. So that's that. And I have a hole saw bit. So that's this medium bag. Let's clean this up and get to the main bag. All right, this main bag is the one with the extendable handle, and that goes up high enough where it's comfortable to drag around. It does have these two handles here that you can pick the whole thing up, and it works pretty well. But with the amount of weight that I have in here, it's actually it can be awkward at times. So it's good to just use these to get in and out of the van and then roll it around to whatever job site I'm working on. So on the outside, it's just a bunch of pouches. I have a tape measure on the back. There's actually another tape measure on the power tool bag I just showed you. I have one of these screwdrivers with multi-bits. I have a little mini hacksaw. Here I have wire strippers. Okay, these are all the wire strippers I might need. Long reach pliers and a utility knife. Channel locks. Okay, these guys come in handy pretty good. In here I have some electrical tools. I have voltage testers. I have a volt meter, an outlet tester. Okay, this thing has been very good so far and it's really helped me out. It's been a good tool to just carry around. I also have in here super glue and some Allen keys, just regular run-of-the-mill stuff you may or may not need. Over here I have some more pliers, okay, and some pencils. Over here I got a vice grips with these covers, so it's more of a soft grip. And these things are great. These are the Milwaukee, and they have this normally on a regular vice grip, it's just a knob. This allows you to put more tension. You can even put like a screwdriver through there and get more leverage so you get a tighter grip. And also with that, I have a pair of scissors. Over here, I have one of these drywall saws. This thing has been great. Adjustable wrench, a couple levels, string level, and another pencil. Now, inside is where everything else is kept. This thing can really hold a lot. So I'm going to move the camera so you can get a better look at what's going on here. So here's a look of everything I have in here, and I'm going to take it out piece by piece and just tell you what I carry. And this has been working out pretty well. I have first this drywall cutout, no measuring device. This works off of magnets, and if you're ever doing a drywall repair and you have an outlet to worry about or a light switch or anything like that, this works out pretty well. I have, this is all my Dremel tool stuff. The Dremel 4000 with attachments and different bits and stuff like that. I'm probably going to find a better way to store this in the bag. Maybe another small bag, because, you know, if you're going to be nitpicky, this is considered a power tool. It'd probably go in the other bag, free up some room here. So I got to figure something out there. I have stud finder. I have full-size hacksaw. One of these things. Temperature laser thing, hammer. And I have, this is kind of a cool tool. I like this. This is a caulking tool. So you can spread it, you can remove it, and all kinds of good stuff. This was a few bucks from Home Depot, Husky brand. I have drywall rasps. PVC cutter, also from Home Depot, just as a general, got to pick something up. Husky's a decent brand. Go to Home Depot and grab it. So I got a lot of Husky blades for the utility knife that we keep over here, and chalk line, pry bar, another tape measure. I have a cheap plastic Empire Speed Square. It's the blue one if it's not showing up in light. And then I have a light that is actually magnetic. So this thing can stick on the side of the van, anything like that. Or it can stick on light fixtures, metal studs, the whole bit. So this thing's kind of cool. Inside, still, I have some marking tools. The Milwaukee Mark Saw or Ink Saw and just a regular Sharpie. I have tiny little trim pry bars. I have a variety of wire brushes in case I need to clean anything off, get some gunk off of stuff. Then I'm going to plead ignorance on this next tool. I'm not sure exactly what the intended purpose for this is, but this works great when you're trying to remove caulk or one of those the rubber around windows and screens and things like that. So this is a good scraper. I don't know what this was originally used for, but that's what I use it for, and it works out great. Putty knife, scraper thing, another pry bar, and then just a variety of screwdrivers. So I got a couple different sizes and the micro ones as well. So that's pretty much it. Now, this is a forever evolving collection of tools. And like I said, I'm not a full-blown professional handyman. This is just stuff that I have on hand in case anything happens and I got an opportunity to make a few extra bucks. So that's pretty much it, minus two other items. In my one pocket, right-hand side, I always carry one of these utility knives. This is the Milwaukee Fastback. And these things are great. They're very inexpensive. They're like $4 or $5. And they come with the blade, and then you get extra blades, no problem. You just switch out the blades. Instead of carrying one of those fancy knives that you know you're gonna lose or get beat up, no problem carrying one of those $5 utility knives. Also, on the right-hand side, on one of my belt loops, I put one of these guys. This is an ID holder. It's retractable that I got from Amazon and just clips right on using that thing there. And on the other end, I put one of these little mini 6-foot tape measures and just clips on there. This way, if I'm measuring anything out, I just pull it up off my waist, measure what I'm measuring, and then you could just forget the whole thing. It slams back into your hip and you'll never lose it. I got a big problem with just putting stuff down and forgetting where I put it. So I'm losing tools left and right. And I almost put that down on the workbench just now and I would lose it forever. Anyway, so that's pretty much it. Those are the tools that I carry around. And like I said, just for a just-in-case, hey, can you situation. But if this keeps going, this could be another leg of the business. And here in New Jersey, you have to be a licensed home improvement contractor in order to do landscaping. So that's one of your licenses you would have to do any sort of landscaping. Now, I'm not talking about just cutting grass. We're talking about doing anything else above that. So as a licensed home improvement contractor, I can do certain things above landscaping interior wise. So there's that aspect of it all that kind of just fell together for me. Anyway, if you like this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin Junk Done. Thanks for watching.